Hello and welcome to part 2 of our diatom training video. In part 1 of the video, we demonstrated different methods of sampling benthic diatoms in rivers according to the European standard. This video is all about processing the collected material in the laboratory and preparation of permanent slides for identification of diatoms in the light microscope. The presented procedure follows the instructions of the European Standard for Water Quality from 2014. For accurate identification of diatoms, it is necessary to remove all organic content from the cells. Therefore, prior to mounting, diatom samples must be cleaned by using a strong oxidizing agent. The European standard mentions several oxidizing agents that can be used for the removal of organic content. In this video, we are going to demonstrate the hot hydrogen peroxide method, which involves less health and safety risks and is also gentler to the diatom thrust tools. Here is the most important equipment and material we are going to use: a fume hood, a centrifuge, a hot plate, a piston-operated pipette, and laboratory glassware shown in this picture. The required chemicals are 30% hydrogen peroxide, concentrated hydrochloric acid, and naphrax as mounting media. In general, the method selection depends on the laboratory equipment and is upon operator's choice. In a first step, the collected field samples have to be well homogenized to get a representative subsample. This can be achieved by thorough shaking of the sampling container and additional mixing of the sample by using a piston-operated pipette. Depending on the concentration of the original sample, transfer approximately 10 ml of diatom suspension into a centrifugation glass tube. If the sample is not sufficiently concentrated, the subsample can be further concentrated by decantation or centrifugation and addition of more sampled material. The goal is to obtain 2 to 3 ml of concentrated diatom suspension to start the cleaning process. When using a centrifuge, make sure that the centrifugation settings do not exceed 2500 rotations per minute. Otherwise, long pennant diatoms are likely to break. We recommend to centrifuge at 2000 rpm for at least 3 minutes. After centrifugation, decant the supernatant with a quick movement of your hand to not lose any sedimented material. Alternatively, you can also extract the supernatant by using a pipette. In the next step, we use hydrogen peroxide as a strong oxidizing agent to remove all organic content from the diatom cells. For this purpose, pipette at least 3 ml of hydrogen peroxide into each glass tube. Since the reaction starts immediately, the glass tubes are covered with glass beads to avoid spilling of material. Transfer the glass tubes to a beaker with hot water and heat for approximately 2 hours at 100 degrees Celsius. Depending on the organic content of the sample, it takes around 1 to 2 hours until all organic material is oxidized. As a result, the reaction dies down and the material is bleached out. If some organic content remains even after 2 hours of boiling, add more hydrogen peroxide and continue with the reaction until all organic material is removed. When there is no more visible reaction in the tubes, remove the tubes from the bath and add 3 to 4 drops of concentrated hydrochloric acid to the samples. This eliminates the remaining hydrogen peroxide and any carbonates or calcareous precipitates. Mix the samples and let them cool down for at least 30 minutes until the reaction stops. In the last step, rinse the diatom suspension 3 times with distilled water to remove any chemicals from the sample. In order to do this, centrifuge the samples at 2000 RPM for 3 minutes, decant the supernatant, add distilled water, and repeat the procedure again. Finally, transfer the cleaned and rinsed diatom suspension with a small amount of distilled water into a labeled glass vial. For identification in the light microscope, the diatom valves still need to be mounted onto a permanent slide using a mountant with high refractive index. The cleaned diatom suspension is too concentrated for mounting and therefore needs to be diluted first. Prepare a glass vial filled up halfway with distilled water. Homogenize the diatom suspension with a pipette and transfer a few drops of the suspension to the glass vial. The diluted suspension should be only slightly milky, with fine particles being just visible when held up to the light. Place two cover slips onto a microscopic slide. Homogenize the diluted suspension and carefully fill up the first cover slip with the diluted sample. To obtain a second subsample with different concentration, fill the glass vial all the way up with distilled water and repeat the procedure with the second cover slip. Alternatively, you can also transfer different volumes of the diatom suspension onto the cover slips. We recommend letting the cover slips dry overnight at room temperature to evenly spread the diatoms over the cover slip. When time is limited, a hot plate or a drying oven can also be used to speed up the process. But consider that diatoms tend to agglomerate when drying at elevated temperatures. Once the cover slips are dry, they are ready for mounting. This must be done in the fume hood. Preheat a hot plate in the fume hood to 110 degrees Celsius. Place 1 to 2 drops of naphrax onto the microscopic slide using a glass rod and invert the cover slips with the dried diatoms quickly onto the drops of naphrax. The microscopic slide is then placed on the hot plate for around 2 minutes until the solvent is evaporated. When no more bubbles are forming, move the slide from the hot plate onto the workbench and quickly but gently press down both of the cover slips. The layer of naphrax should be without air bubbles and as thin as possible. Excessive drops of naphrax can be removed afterwards with a scalpel. Finally, label the slides and check under the microscope. For high quality slides, the diatom valves should be evenly distributed on the cover slip and not significantly clumped. Ideally, there should be 5 to 15 valves, but not less than 1 per field of view when viewed at 1000 times magnification.